Hey, how's it going, guys? Pyro here, and welcome to a brand new series. This series, I'm going to be going towards the Completionist Cape. That means I'm going to have to get 120 in three different skills: Dungeoneering, Slayer, and Invention. Going to have to do all the quests and some other requirements. Going to be throwing in a bunch of bossing in this one, of course, and we're going to be trying to get that Fang once and for all from Araxxi, but hopefully you guys enjoy the series. Okay, another Beastmaster kill. I think we're due for another drop. Let's see what we're gonna get here. Finally! We finally get it! Oh, that is amazing. There we go, bank. 12 mil, wow. So that is my, what kill is that? Like 50 or something? Beastmaster 47. Finally get a codex. I had to buy the onslaught with points, if you don't remember. So now I can buy an ability. This is gonna be great. This is the first time. Okay, back at the bank, we got our codex open. Let's go with Corruption Shot. I think it's going to be the next best. There we go. We unlocked the ability. So now we have another basic. That's going to be really nice, especially for AoEs. Now that I'm done my Ascension grind, that would have been nice back then. But I'm sure I can find some more use for it for Slayer and whatnot. So something else I'd like to improve on this series is Solo Nex. So I don't have full Ancient Ceremonial yet, but I have been doing a bit of that in the past 2 weeks, so let's take a peek at my progress. Tech ceremonial. There's two masks. All I need is the gloves still, but I can't seem to find them. Can you tell I just watched Rocky there? But the kills were going a lot better. I was still about 10 kills dry of the gloves and like 10 different 40 kill count sessions. So I got through Blood Phase, went to kill Kuror, and guess what I got? I got a pair of gloves that I didn't see till a bit after, and I took my eye off Nex and didn't really realize what was happening. Didn't see the prison call out. Went to grab the gloves and I couldn't grab them. Prisoned right a square in front of them and killed. I was just ridiculously overly pissed off. Like I didn't even want to commentate a clip at that point. I was just devastated, but kept going, and here's the next few kills. And after another 6 kills, we did finally manage to get them again from the ice minion, or the blood minion rather. So I didn't get prisoned, luckily, but I got the hell out of there. I was just kept making stupid mistakes, just completely triggered, but I was happy once I finally got that. So after this, I was able to go back to Nex without doing kill count. Makes it so much faster. I was able to practice a lot more. So next video, we'll hopefully be getting a few drops, at least one, hopefully. I'm going to be doing a lot of Nex in the next few days, so look forward to that. Okay, got a pair of dailies to hand in. Here is a Slayer one that I didn't manage to reroll. So let's hand this one in. And then what we really want is this Dungeoneering daily, which is going to give me my first level, level 100. I've been really neglecting these dailies since I maxed in February, so I've missed about like 40 mil XP, but we're on it now, so there's my first level. Alright, another step closer to level 107. Been doing a lot of fishing, so let's disassemble this rod-o-matic. For 450k, that's going to give us 106 invention, one level away now. I have a good amount of stuff in the queue to be disassembled, so I think this shouldn't take too much longer. Beastmaster loot coming right in. Let's see what he's got. Not too bad. We got some elks, more logs for fletching, and some talismans if I ever get around to using those. Next, hard clue casket all done here. So we have the Ring of Fortune on. Let's see if we can get something unique and maybe something better. Yep, that's a big no on that. Pulling each, I guess, is decent. 236 clues down. This is what the tab is looking like if you haven't seen it in a while. Getting pretty big now. Got a lot of rune sets and some other little rares. Nothing amazing, no dies yet. Okay, next Rax kill up. Let's see if we can ride that Codex luck. Let's see what we get here. So this is post-commentary while I'm editing this video. I've done about 50 kills. I think you saw in that earlier that I was at 833 KC. I'm at about 880 right now after this video, and that little montage was pretty much shows what I got throughout this whole last 2 weeks. Pretty well nothing. I'm glad I'm not focusing on that as my main goal, but I'm still hoping that I get something, but I'm not, so I should probably stop putting so much time into Raxor. But that's pretty much a little update of what I've been doing. No leg drops at all either, so I guess we'll keep doing that a bit more casually now. Hey, there's a drop. I don't know if I've got one of these yet. Staff of Light. Very cool. Add to my collection. I'm pretty sure that's my first one, so that's pretty neat. We are 26k away from 111 magic, I want to say. I think we're at 111. And we are also 63k away from 103 Slayer. Pretty much just starting with Slayer, but we got a long road to go. 20 mil just about, so it's gonna be quite a big grind. Alright, we got ourselves our first combat level of the series. There is 111 magic, so that is 43-ish mil XP. About half of our ranged XP actually, so we got about 60 mil to go to 120. We'll probably get a good chunk of that done with 120 Slayer, we'll see. But just about done this task, and 45k till next Slayer level. Okay, and just because I want to get this level tonight, because I'm not sure how much more time I'm going to have the rest of this week, just going to go ahead and siphon this crystal rod that I've been saving with the crystal tool siphon. Let's go ahead. And that is going to give me 107. Very nice. Now we can make the alchemical onyx in order to make the luck of the dwarves, which I've been really itching to make recently. So let's go discover that and get ready to make this. Okay, so here, let's go ahead and make our alchemical onyx ring. And there it is done. Let's enchant it. There we go, luck of the dwarves, awesome. We can now upgrade this Ring of Fortune. We have the best in slot luck ring. That is really awesome. Been really wanting this for a while, so we can now get the signet ring. Although I don't think I'll ever get it, but now we have the chance at it, and we can boost elite clue rewards, I think, now, as well as raids. I think Rax as well. So maybe this is gonna give me what I need to get the Fang. So if you guys remember, I used to do an hour or two of Corp every episode until I got my Divine, or my Elysian, sorry, and my Corp pet. So I think I'm going to do the same with God Wars Dungeon 2. I'm going to switch it up with a different boss every time. But I'd like to work towards some of the gear and the weapons. There we go. There's my first Zerosian, not Zamorakian. Not too bad. First hour, we get an Essence. I don't believe I have one of those yet, so that's the first piece of the puzzle there. And there we go, there's another Zerosian Essence. 2-in-1 trip, I think that seems pretty decent. That is unnoted, that's kind of weird. There we go. And we will take that. Alright, all done with that hour at Vindicta. We did miss a few kills because I had to bank. Forgot a few things, but now that I got my preset done, we should be more streamlined. So we managed to get 2 Zerosian Essence. Which is pretty nice, I think, for my first hour. I don't have any of those yet. I have to brush up about how you actually make the gear. But in the end, we managed to get 2.4 mil cash. I'm going to be doing this kind of similar to how I used to do corp, probably do like an hour or two every week until we can get the Lance and get our components for best in slot perks. And there we go, 103 Slayer, doing these air roots. These are a lot easier than I remember them being. 2 mil until the next level, that's going to keep increasing as well, I'm sure. So let's continue with this. Finish that journal from the... Oh, there, nice. I got to finish... got to put this mask together for another comp requirement, so that is good to get that drop. It's hard to see them with this sand, it clips through things. But let's elk these up and finish this task. Alright, all finished up with the ascension task. Really fast, got a few more keystones, not like we need them. We have like 500 or something in the bank. Maybe I'll get around to using those in the next video. In a coming video, I should say, not the next video. But let's see. Shadow creatures, I'm pretty sure those are decent melee XP and fairly quick. So let's go ahead and do those. Alright, next kill. Got the ring on. Let's see if we can get anything. What is that? Next kill. Please be something. Holy fuck. Well, I've been getting absolute junk today from racks. So let's see what we can get here. Oh my god. Not expecting anything good here, but let's see what we're gonna get. What? So that about sums up my experience with bossing the last 2 weeks, but that's about all we've got for this episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the first episode of the new series. I think this is going to be a nice long one with tons of content, I'm hoping. So I will hopefully see you guys next week with another episode. I've got a bit more content that I've gotten in the day that I've been editing this, so we should be well on our way for another episode. But I also have another new series coming out hopefully tomorrow or the next day, so keep an eye out for that as well. Also like to give a little shout out to our Discord server that we now have. We've had it for a while, but haven't really got it set up yet. So it's all kind of set up now with chat channels and the rune info bot and whatnot. There's about 20 of us, so if you want to join, you can just click the link under the video in the description and it'll bring you right here. We also do have an in-game friends chat, which I've had for a while. If you want to join that, it's just my name, Pyrodexx, and everyone who joins gets a friend add, and you do get ranks based on kind of loosely based on how long you've been in the chat.